Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Here we are today in Yermo, California, and I'm doing this classic building here. I'm painting a little sign for him here and doing kind of a logo on the other side. And I don't know what the population is here, but it's not very big, I can tell you that. I think this is probably one of the smallest towns I've ever painted in. And it's actually closest to the old part of Route 66 that I've ever painted at. And I've got some more work to do here after I get these windows and different things done. So it's looking kind of interesting. We're going into week four of waiting for the van to get finished. So here's a little update on the van. As you can see, they've been working on it and they've got the whole motor pretty much taken apart to get out of the van. And that's a good thing because there's quite a bit to taking this motor out of this van. And so the boys over there have been working very diligently, but they ran into an issue. They did get the motor out of the van, as you can see here in these pictures, which was a great feeling for me because I know that is a challenge. You can see right down to the transmission there. Here is the old motor sitting on the floor. That's awesome. They had the new motor, but it was the wrong motor. So now we're ordering another one to actually go in the van.
But in the meantime, we're gonna be riding the bikes and going out painting some windows, making a little money to help pay for all this stuff. And you guys stay tuned because I got more coming from the RV Bandwagon right about now. Check this out.
So this is where I'm painting. It's called Thrift N More. I refer to it as a last stop thrift shop. In fact, Ron, the owner of the place, kind of adopted that term as the tagline for the Thrift N More. And I'll actually be painting that tagline under their logo on the front of the store. As you can probably see from this video, they do have quite a few interesting and unique items in this store. When I first entered the old building, all I could think to myself is Mr. Megorium's Wonder Emporium. Back in its heyday, this building was actually a big gas station and garage. And from what I understand, actually sold the most gasoline in the whole state of California during that time. And from what I can see, they actually continue the tradition by selling possibly the most unique items in California. So remember, if you're ever passing by Yermo on your way up to Las Vegas, you might want to make a quick stop here at Thrift N More and take a look at all the cool stuff. And my sign as well. Well, that's about it from Thrift N More, but incredibly, I've got more coming from Yermo right about now. Check this out. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. You can see behind me, ladies and gentlemen, we have some pretty amazing sculpture going on with this dinosaur. I'm out here in Dagget, just beyond Yermo, and this guy, Martin out here, has this incredible yard of sculptures. This is a private property and you're not allowed to come out here, although he did give me permission. So I'm able to come out here, check it out, and show you some of his awesome sculptures. There's actually a group of folks out here that put this stuff together, but I gotta tell you, it is amazing. Check this out. Welcome to Dagget, California, which is just outside of Yermo, California, right off the I-40. If you've ever been down this stretch of highway, you might have noticed some of this artwork sitting off to the side of the road. Odds are you probably did notice because there are so many sculptures out here. In fact, Martin, the property owner and a former commercial welder, along with a few of his creative welder friends, have created hundreds of sculptures out here. Turns out they're pretty protective over the artwork. So I was courteous and only recorded a few of the pieces to help protect their privacy. I think you can get a sense of the dedication and detail these boys put into these quality sculptures, even though I was only able to record just a few of them. So remember, if you're ever cruising down the I-40, headed towards New Mexico or something and you see these sculptures, don't stop and bother these folks. They're really nice to let me come in, but they do enjoy their privacy. Until next time, I've got more coming from the RV bandwagon. Yeah, you guessed it. Right about now. Check this out.